I'm Jennifer Angel, this is Stars Virgo. Okay, now this month for May, there's a Pluto and Uranus square on the 20th. Now this is going to affect your personal life and how you relate to those that are closest. So there's likely to be an incident that it's impossible to avoid. Okay, now it can be unsettling or confronting, but also very healing. So it has the power to really clean the slate so you can move forward. And of course, you know what that means. Whenever we, it's like the cycle of order and chaos. Whenever you're in the chaos time, everything sort of is up in the air. And it's almost you've got to go through that chaos to be able to get to the other point, to get to the new energy that follows from that. Okay, so that's very much this month. It's on the 20th, but the lead up, because this is a major square aspect, because Pluto and Uranus are both pretty heavy duty planets, it'll be, felt, you'll pretty well feel it sort of building to a crescendo, okay? But as I said, it will be, it's very healing as well. Now, there's a solar eclipse this month as well, on the 10th, and this will help you just rethink the structure of your life. So this, what you need to be careful about or mindful of is that you see things, people, situations for what they are and not necessarily what you would like them to be, okay? And being a very grounded Virgo, you shouldn't have too much trouble with that, Virgo, all right? Now let's have a look at your more professional side of your life. So your career can take off this month. It's like new energy all in your 10th house. Venus trans into your 10th house, all to do with your career and business. Earlier in the month on the 10th, on the same day, on the 10th, there's a solar eclipse in your 9th house. And in your 9th house, is this going to just help you review your life and review your life against where you are and what your purpose in life is? So, what are you working towards rather than the mundane, everyday details of life, of which, of course, as a Virgo, you're very good at. But with the ninth house just helps you open up, be a lot broader, be a lot more visionary, and think about where you're heading, so, and what you're doing today, how that is helping you to get to where you are. Even if you're not in the place that you want to be, and rarely are we, because once we get to a goal, we set another goal, so we're always striving to get to that next level and, to better ourselves in one area of our life. So even if you're not, doing what you do, generally everything that we do in life serves us in one way or another. So rather than being self-critical or thinking about, you're doing what you don't want to do, look at it and say, well, how is this helping me in even a small way to fulfill your visionary purpose of where you want to end up, okay? So this month and all to do around your career and purpose this month, you can really get some insights or some of those Oprah aha type realizations, okay? And that's great, because once you get that, then as a Virgo, you know how to put the pieces down and into action to move forward and actually make it a reality. All right, now at the end of the month, on the 28th, Venus and Jupiter are going to conjunct. So this is great. This is a fabulous transit. It really is a very beneficial transit. You can expect some good news to come through of business and money. Okay, so your hard work and patience finally, can pay off. So stay positive. And my angel advice for you for the month is, you never know, you can be pleasantly surprised this month. Anything can happen, so stay open. I'm Jennifer Angel. Thanks for watching, Virgo. See you next month.